What's up, guys? It's your boy Coded99 again, and welcome back to my channel. Ooh, it's been long. Anyways, if you're new to my channel, what I do is to offer my 10 cents on how we can grow in various aspects of our lives as individuals. And today, I'll be touching the topic of cutting people off.
So you want to cut me off, Abby?
What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you too?
Anyways, as I was saying, I'm not advocating for enmity or keeping grudges in any way, no. I solely believe that we should try as much as possible to live peacefully with everyone, okay? That's a check. What I'm saying is there are some type of people that you don't necessarily have to be close with. You can love them from a distance because 2020 has shown us a lot of bad tools from left and right, and I think we've had enough. Going into 2021, some people are already, you know, trying to get their mind straight, focus on their growth, their career, their family, peace of mind, and, you know, doing things that makes them happy. So in that sense, I think it is necessary to cut people off sometimes, and it doesn't really come easy. It doesn't. For some of us, it's hard because, like, you know, you must have given them the benefit of the doubt over a long period of time, but their behavior and what they do keeps affecting you somehow. I think you can take comfort in knowing that some people are best appreciated and loved from a distance, and that's absolutely fine. Having said that, there are various red flags that draws your attention to the fact that this set of people need to be avoided or, you know, loved from a distance. One of them is negativity. It's like these people are just talented in giving out negative vibes, you know. Even when everybody around is trying to set the atmosphere right, or, you know, make things lively or positive, these people are just there. You know, they are there either personally or, you know, in a group of people. They are just there to, you know, they have this way of draining your energy. It's stressful physically, mentally, even spiritually. It's stressful, you know. Attitude is everything. And if someone keeps on giving off negative attitudes or negative vibes always, note, sometimes people do that maybe based on situation or friends argue or whatever, just for a short period of time, and we move on. But if this person's zone is like a constant K or almost a constant, then attitude is everything. And you don't want someone who constantly gives this negative attitude, negative vibes, or, you know, pessimistic reactions to your suggestions or your ideas or whatever. Even when you tell your little success stories, or, you know, when you give opinions and all, I'm not saying it doesn't happen occasionally, it does, but if this is this person's attribute every time, it's not healthy for you. You know, some of these things might actually be bringing you down rather than lifting you up. That's not what you want. So I think this is one red flag that we can watch out for and know that, okay, it's time to jackpot. Another red flag to watch out for is if the person is being selfish and they love taking more than they can give. Your relationship with anyone should not be a burden. It should be a blessing, right? So if the person keeps taking, and bear in mind, it doesn't have to be material things. It could be time, it could be your energy, it could be information, it could be ideas. If there is no exchange, then I think you need to watch if you're being used, or if you're just in the season where you're fortunate, you know, to give more at that period in time, or if you're that person's sponsor or mentor and you're in that position to just give, you know. If it falls into none of these constraints, then you may need to move, you know what I'm saying? Another red flag to watch out for is pride. Some people are so proud to the extent that it stinks. I once had a guy come up to me then, was my schoolmate. We had an assignment, and I had done mine. I understood what was to be done, so I had done mine. And he came up to me asking for my help for his own assignment. And he presented it in a way that, okay, if I help him, I think I said I didn't want to help him. So he said, okay, yeah, if I help him, it would give me more experience. I would gain more practice and I would understand the topic better. And I was like, really? Is this the card you want to play? Like, you know, you need my help, but you're making it seem like I would benefit from helping you. You know, I know it's one of the laws in the 48 laws of power that when seeking for help, appeal to people's self-interest, not to their mercy or gratitude. But that's wrong. That's manipulative. You get? So I was like, I can smell your manipulative intentions right here. I can smell your pride that you just don't want to come to the level where you can actually beg and say, okay, please help me, I need your help. You still want to feel superior, and those kind of people are not healthy to be close with. Another sub-trait you would see is manipulation. You see, there's a lot to say under these topics, but I'm trying to make this video as short as possible. So if you need more explanation or you need me to talk more on this topic, just write it in the comment section, then I'll make a more elaborate video. Another red flag you need to watch out for is immaturity. Maturity could be relative, right? But there are some people that are so immature that it's so glaring. I once picked up my phone to check up on an old friend, and I was like, hey Alpha, how are you doing? What's up? Blah blah blah. And my friend was like, hi, how are you doing? You didn't check up on me, you forgot me, this and that, that and this. And I was like, hold up bruv. I called you. Number one, I called you. Number two, we both didn't check up on each other. Number three, why is it my fault that we didn't check up on each other and I'm the one to blame? You know that we're adults and we're busy. It's normal. So why are you playing the blame game? Why trying to blame someone for not checking up on you? And if you needed them to check up on you, why not check up on them? As simple as that. This is just one of the scenarios that immaturity can play out, but there are various scenarios. And as I said, let me know in the comment section if you want me to speak more on these topics, because I have a lot of gist to throw out there, you know. There are lots of red flags to watch out for on the topic of cutting people out. Another one you can watch out for is respect, you know, lack of mutual respect. For example, you know, someone doesn't respect your time, your energy, your contribution. These are also little things, but they matter. So basically, noticing these red flags in some people and still choosing to be close to them can affect you in various ways. It can get you more frustrated or make you normalize or indulge their behavior. The thing is, if it's something you want to work on, you can have a conversation with that person. Let them know what they do that affects you in certain ways or areas. If not, if need be, love them from a distance, appreciate them from a distance. In fact, forgive them and pray for them. That's like the best you can do for your sanity and for your peace of mind. And in the meantime, just filter out the things or people you don't want in 2021. You don't need toxic people around you. So it's a wrap for today. I wish you a Merry Christmas in advance. If you want me to go more elaborate on the topic of cutting people off, please let me know in the comment section. And if you're new to my channel, please do make sure you like, comment and subscribe. I would really appreciate the support. And you can also share this video wherever you want. Until next time, make sure you keep your soul beautiful. Peace out.